If I'm Doc Rivers, if I'm Danny Ainge, you know what I do today? I call up Jordan Crawford's agent, and I tell the agent, get your player the hell out of here. Goodbye. Wave him. Out of here. See you later. Loser. Idiot. Idiot. Speaking to what Beadle did in the update, what he just told you, there was a little scramble right at the end of the game. Little scuffle. As the Knicks are coming off the floor and the Celtics are coming off the bench.
Trash talk.
And this started with Black Sports Online, which is the go-to site for things of this nature. Black Sports Online brought you the Honey Nut Cheerios comment from Kevin Garnett to Melo in the first place.
You know what? I haven't been there recently. I got to go back to that site.
BSO, courtesy of Jermaine Wiggins. He clued us into it. And there's not a morning goes by that I don't check it out, because that's where all the good stuff comes from. So Black Sports Online started this business where they clipped the video and watch what Jordan Crawford, who did not play a second, thank God, in his full, you know, warm-ups, because he never took them off, as he's walking off the floor, how he gets into it with a couple of the Knicks. And loosely translating what he says is, bleeper, bleeper, bleeped your wife.
Basically, yeah. That's a good way to do it.
That was a
relatively sanitized way and effective way of translating, Mike.
Saying that to Carmelo.
No, bleeper, bleeper.
And I'm not sure if he was speaking about Garnett. Is Garnett the bleeper bleeper who bleeped his wife or whoever? I don't know. And no one knows, but they clipped the video. They did some lip reading. Deadspin has also done this,
Cheerio B.
I believe. Correct. And what Jordan Crawford says to Carmelo Anthony coming off the floor is, bleeper bleeper bleeped your wife. Out of here, loser. You jackass. You clown. What are you doing? What are you doing? This is just what we discussed. You're keeping your mouth shut and winning games. And you've got focus. You're not instigating them. You're not poking them. You're not giving them any extra reason. You're going out and doing your job. You're being professional. And you're on your way. And this clown, this scrub, this joker who sucks, who, for anyone like me who doesn't like the NBA, watch 10 seconds of Jordan Crawford play the game of basketball, and you will immediately flip back over to the NHL Network, because it is reason one I can't stand that league. Guy has zero idea how to play. Probably very talented, but what a joker. Clown. He sucks. And Doc Rivers finally said enough and sat him down. Thank God. And this is the guy that's now going to give the Knicks reason? That's not going to poke that bear or get, you know, I don't know if Carmelo's mentally strong enough to use that as motivation and actually thrive with it, but I don't want to find out. What are you doing? If I am Doc Rivers, I say to Jordan Crawford, see you later, clown.
Yeah, and you know, I look at it from the standpoint of, because the first thing I said was, you didn't even play. What are you talking about? Shut your mouth. Like, it's almost one thing if you get on the floor. You get on the floor and you're Jason Terry and you want to talk smack with J.R. Smith, have a blast. If you're out there and you play the kind of game that Terry did last night, great. All power to you.
But I'm not
into it.
But
in that league, it's allowed.
But even not in this circumstance. Not in this circumstance. The Celtics said, within the last 48 hours, let them talk. Let them do their thing. Let them build extra pressure on themselves and let them do whatever. This is game 7 for us, and we're going to put our hard hats on. And now they've clawed back into this thing, and they've made it a series. And this loser, this horrible basketball, this horrible excuse.
Please, I guess shorts are on fire.
For a basketball player who's got no idea how to win, clearly, this loser on the end of your bench is going to say something and give Carmelo Anthony more reason like he needs it. Out of here. Get out of here.
I think Carmelo said something like that too, right? Like, I don't even want to mention his name so y'all don't write it in the paper or something like that.
Whatever
the line was. Mike, he clearly acts like he plays.
Fire him. Fire him today. And send that message to your team. You stay on focus. You're doing what you're doing. You have no use for that clown. He hurt you when he's on the floor, and now he's going to do this off the floor? Horrible. And let me say something further too, because this reminds me. When just the appropriateness of it overall, win, lose, or draw, playoffs or not, and maybe this could even go back to the Garnett comment, didn't you all out there, Boston fans, freak out when Ted Johnson, in a radio interview in Houston, had the temerity to answer a question about ugly wives, and he brings up Vince Wilfork, and you people out there My God, the outrage. And I don't blame you. It was an inappropriate thing for Ted to do. And he knows it. And he knew it the second he said it. But you all lost it. And the moral outrage. Oh, my God. You couldn't believe the moral outrage at Ted Johnson. How do you feel about Jordan Crawford telling another man, this guy bleeped your wife? How do you feel about that? Is that appropriate? Or is it just because he's in green, it's okay? You know, oh, I see. So Ted was saying something about a patriot, so it is a huge moral, you know, like, oh, my God, Ted Johnson's the worst person on earth. But Jordan Crawford, not really a word about it, huh? Because he's talking about a Nick. Oh, I get it. So now it's just we're back to laundry. It just depends what team you're on, like a bunch of 12-year-olds out here. What's worse, what Ted Johnson said or what Jordan Crawford said? Either way, to me, it's in the same ballpark. It's in the same boat. Where's the outrage? Where's the moral outrage over Jordan Crawford or even going back to what Garnett said with the Honey Nut Cheerios to start it? Doesn't seem to me like there's much outrage over that.
Well, because most people don't even have, you know, they don't want to waste a breath on Jordan Crawford. That's half the problem, Mike. I don't think they're perfectly synonymous.
They're not. I said, they're in the general ballpark.
So, you know, to me, they're a little bit different. But even so, like I told you, my biggest issue with it is, look, I don't know the kind of trash talk that goes on in that league. I'm sure there's stuff that's ten times worse said during the course of a game. He didn't play. He wasn't even out there.
Tony, even if he played, don't give them any more reason. Even if he played.
Okay, so you're talking then from a competitive standpoint.
I'm talking about the timing of it.
I just think it's like, who are you?
I mean, it makes it worse. Don't get me wrong. But I don't think it was the time for Garnett to do it.
I mean, who's going to be talking trash next? The trainer? Like, is he going to be talking of Carmelo next?
You're lucky.
He doesn't get off the bench either.
Right.
Any assert?
So, again, if I'm the Celtics today, right now, Jordan Crawford, bye-bye. You're fired.